I hate them, don't you? I mean, we've done a really good job in the UK killing most of them off, but in the summertime we do get the odd moth, the odd spider, the odd daddy long legs, and well, anyway, got this from Lidl. It was £12.99, and it's a UV insect killer lamp. UV light lures flying insects into the trap. Well, spiders don't fly, but they do crawl and go up ceilings, which is weird. Yet they've not figured out how to get out of a bath. So I was wondering about this the other day, actually. If an entire house had a room that had rooms that were entirely bath shaped, would it contain spiders? We don't know. Anyway, easy and safe to use, no chemicals. And it's got Lion technology. Okay then. No memory effect, low self-discharge, constantly high performance, and efficient and environmentally friendly. Well, it's not environmentally friendly if you're an insect, but you know. yes. And on the side, it says, maybe I should go to the English side. The best word. There we go. Easy and safe to use, no chemicals, integrated in a rechargeable lithium ion battery. For indoor use, yes, you can't take it through butterfly world, that would be cruel and mean. UV light lures flying insects into the trap. Works for up to 8 hours, fully charged in brackets. Splash proof, IPX4, don't know what that means, but if you're technologically advanced or just randomly have that information, you'll know what that means. With on-off switch and practical handle. I hate it when they start struggling to fill packaging up. Just stop. You should have just stopped at splash proof. Safe to use due to insulated plastic housing and protective grill. Ooh, it's a grill. Is it a George Foreman grill as well? Let's get out of the box. Enough yakety yak. And this is the point where I should have remembered to get some scissors, but I didn't. Okay. I'm in. There we go. Oh, it's a USB cable, that's good. I wonder if it'll do data as well. That'd be handy to know, won't it? I'll probably put in a caption if it does data. USB cable suitable for HG or for only. That's probably just the make and model of the thing. That's good. Oh, it's USB, but they've not given me the actual plug. Oh, that's a bit crap, isn't it? Yeah, not giving me the actual plug. Oh, that's quite a beefy sort of one. You know, it's not tacky, it's a bit rubberized sort of stuff. Does it leave a nail mark? Yeah, it's leaving a nail mark, so it's like a rubberized plastic. And there we go. That's it. Does it have a... Oh, there's the input thing. That's where you put it in, look. But does it have a bug release tray, you know? Because if this gets choked up with bugs... I don't think it has it? Gosh, it's already got a bit of charge in it. Well, on camera, on my LCD screen for my camera, this is showing up blue. But it is actually a nice violet colour. That's nice. I like the switch. It's like got this rubbery bit on it. I love that sort of texture. But the switch inside's a nice click. There we go. But I don't think I should stick my finger in it. Oh, I can't get my finger in it, so that's nice and safe. But I am tempted to put some metal in it to see if it'll go zap. I will do that, because I've got to. I've got to make sure, haven't I? Let's see, though, if there's some sort of thing that I'm missing. What's it smell like? Oh, yeah, it smells of new plastic. I love that smell. This is the rather thick book, but it's probably in about 50,000 languages. See, look, I've opened it straight up onto... I'm presuming that's French. Port de Gans de Protection. Whatever. That's German, maybe. Or maybe Norwegian or something. Where's the English? There it is. So the English is this many pages. Oh yeah. Number one is the practical handle, probably. Number two is the switch. Number three is the protective grill. And number four is something else. Intended use. This product is intended for use in the indoors only in a private domestic environment and not for commercial use. Okay then. Risk of electric shock! Do not touch the high voltage grill while the product is in operation. A small residual charge still exists for a few minutes after the product has been switched off. Good, good, good. This is stuff that I need to know. Danger of explosion? Never recharge, non-recharge. Oh. Well, that's not fun. Charging the product. No, I don't think there's no. There is no. You'd have expected some sort of twisty bit to get the dead bugs out, so instead you've got to rattle it around like this. Which means if it's a big spider that gets in there, you might be rattling it around. So I'm wondering if this will work any better than my organic version. My Venus fly trap that I got. I fed it a moth the other day. There's a moth in that one. Yes. I've just tried this and no, it is not a data cable. It really is just a charging cable. It does seem quite really good quality though. So it'd be great just to charge your phone up, but not for anything else. And let's get this unwrapped. Don't you just love these twisty things? Oh, it's the best part, isn't it? Not! It's quite a long cable, actually. There you are. So if you want a longer cable to charge your phone up, I suppose it's quite good. It's got one of them things on it, look. What's it say on this? It just says stuff, really. Can't really make that out. This USB cable is suitable for HG04701 only. No idea what that means. I have been reading the instruction book as well, and you cannot operate this whilst it's charging. Well, you can, but it says that you shouldn't, which means that most people will. I'm really wanting to know now if it's going to make a zappy sort of sound. So I'm going to have to try and find a screwdriver that's not going to shock me. I want to hear noises. I couldn't find a screwdriver, but I did find this piece of tat, which I hate selfie sticks so much, but I do own one because sometimes when I make a YouTube video, if I'm walking down the street whilst reading comments or reading anything out, then I do need a selfie stick to hold the camera steady. Most of the time I just use my own arm, you know, technology. Anyway, I'm dithering. Let's turn this off, because it says it does all the charge, and we're just going to doppel that in. Maybe if I turn it on. Maybe it's got a capacitor or something that self-extinguishes. I don't know. I'm not bigclav.com. It just spark a bit, look. Can you see that? So now we know. Oops. It's not been on a full charge, but... It does. It's not as good as the fly zapper that I got. No, it's not as good as the fly zapper. These are great. I've had these for years now, and it still works. And they're really good for... I mean, I suppose they've got the uses. I mean, this is good because obviously this will just be stood still in your bathroom or something like that, which is where this is going actually, because I've got a window with a tree right outside of it, and you get all sorts of bugs crawling and flying off the tree, which is really annoying. So this could be on its own in the bathroom, whereas I'm hardly going to be stood in the bathroom for hours on end near the window waiting for a bug to fly in. But what I mean is... obviously on this one you've got to press a button down. I mean, I suppose you could just stick this down. It's got that slight whistling noise as well. I don't know if you can hear it, but... That. And these are much more zappier. I'll just do a demonstration with my selfie stick again. I'll just zap my selfie. Ah! See what I mean? Yeah, I got these. I don't think they make these in Poundland anymore. I think these ones are like uber dangerous. But yeah, these are good. I like these. Yeah, these are good. I love these. Oh, also as well, it does turn you a bit sadistic because what you end up doing is if you do get a fly or a wasp or something on this, you just want to end up cooking it and you just keep pressing the button and all the steam comes up and it's like, cooked wasp. So yeah, I think these have got different benefits. This is good for on the go wasp zapping, and it does kill wasps. It's good. Well, it stuns wasps more than kills them. It does kill flies, but wasps, it does stun them into either that thing where they spin around really, 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 really fast, or it just makes them stop flying in and then just crawl, and then you can dispose of them as you see fit. Whereas this, I do see the point of just leaving it switched on. And since it's 8 hours you get out of it, that's quite good, I suppose. I mean, that's all the way through the night. So I might be able to leave the window open or something in the bathroom. And yeah, that's... I don't know if I'm happy with it yet. I'll do a follow-up video of this and I'll tell you if it's any good. But for now, I'm so far happy with it. I'll give it a good charge up. And when I remember, I'll do the follow-up video for it. And I'll be able to tell you if it's any good. And is this going to fit in? Can you imagine? I'm going to give it a charge up. It says there's a light in this. I'm a bit annoyed though that they've not bothered to supply the plug. You see, now I've got to find another charger cable. I'll use this one. This is one I stuck eyes on because I think it makes it look funny. Look, it's like, oh, really? So stupid. Oh, just plug me in. There we are. Looks like looks like it's eating. For now, scraps and bell me and bye bye. Let's have a red light on when it's charging. Oh, red light, yeah, goes green when it's charged, it said in the book. There we go.